The Vietnam War. Yep. It's South Vietnam versus North Vietnam. Capitalists versus communists. And all hell was to break loose. North Vietnam reigned Asia as a communist force and were threatening to take over its brother in South Vietnam. People feared that if North Vietnam were to take over further countries and to force them into communism, then it would spread like a domino effect, and the legacy of communism would take over countries. The United States took this issue into their own hands and decided to take on North Vietnam with members of SETO on their side. During this time, people got killed and scars of memories were left on the people who survived. Everyone tried to flee from danger, and only a few did not make it on the way due to the fact of the opposition's attacks. Not only did this war affect Vietnam, but it split nations who set their troops in half. People were confused whether it was the right decision to send their troops to Vietnam. This still did not mean any good to the war, as the threat of communism was increasing immensely. A South Vietnam resident by the name of Kim Phuc felt the pain of this war as she was captured running naked down the street because soldiers had severely burnt her skin into shreds. Others were unlucky as they had to see their own brothers die and be buried within their own sight as seen in this picture. Our Aussies giving them a hand. As people and soldiers were suffering in South Vietnam, the Australian soldiers took it in their own initiative to help them. If people were severely injured and needed medical treatment, the Australians would be there. If families needed safety, the Australians would be there. If people needed food or water, the Australians would be there. Not only did these soldiers come in aid of the Vietnamese, but they also learned how to communicate in Vietnamese, and they taught South Vietnamese soldiers tactics which improved their self-defense. And when along the journey, these soldiers learned how to bond and grow closer to these unfortunate people living in Vietnam. Their new home. The recent Australian soldiers had helped them get through the war, and now it was in the Vietnamese decision to move to a new and democratic country. People had the choice of going anywhere around the world, but some found it in their own right to pay back the Australian soldiers who served them by starting a new life in Australia. So people packed their bags and were sent to Australia for a fresh start. Now they could call their new home Australia. Vietnam were now in the top 10 migrant groups that were entering Australia. Today there is an estimated 174,000 people living in Australia with whom have a Vietnamese background.